It was decent for me. Let me say it like that. It was regular for me, like, you know, because I grew up here and this. But when I look at other people, some moving around and shit, I see how other people growing up and how they life here. Like, so it'd probably be hard for them. That shit ain't the same as I see everybody else. But to me, it's regular. My mom was there.
King Von was one rapper who, despite having a massive criminal history, was able to captivate rap lovers with his style of music. Born David Burnett, there's still so much that a lot of us didn't know about the 26-year-old rapper who was taken too soon. So in today's video, let's take a look at 8 things you never knew about King Von. Before we get started, make sure to leave a like on this video if you're a fan of King Von. Also, if you'd like to join this month's giveaway of a brand new iPhone 12, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video until the end to find and comment the hidden message. Good luck! Number 8. His songs were an autobiography. King Von was the type of rapper who stood out from the others with his story-centric style. He's had his fair share of run-ins with the law. During his last sentence, where he had to spend more than 3 years in jail on charges including possession of a firearm, King Von wrote his songs and even read a lot of books. He had more than enough time to do this while he was locked up, and this journey to incarceration started when he got sent away for about 3.5 years in Cook County Jail when he was just 9 years old. However, his style of rapping was able to capture a lot of people's attention as his followers on various social media pages grew to millions with his songs, gaining a lot of views on YouTube. Number 7. His father and grandfather were both convicts. Growing up on the south side of Chicago, Illinois, King Von lived in the Parkway Gardens complex, which was a prime center for poverty and violence. However, his mom did her best to keep the family fed and clothed, especially as she had to do it on her own. The rapper never knew his father growing up, as he was already in prison before King Von was born. While his father was in jail, King Von was already having his minor brushes with crime until he finally met him when he was about 8 years old. However, he died about a year after that, and King Von had to rely heavily on his mother for everything. It gets even crazier when you realize that the rapper's grandfather was none other than David Barksdale. This American gangster was popularly called King David, and he founded the Black Disciples. This was an association that King Von was also a part of later in his life, but the rapper continued to deny this. Number 6. He played baseball in high school. Despite gangs being a huge part of his life growing up, King Von had some semi-playful moments where he acted like a proper teenager. This time it was playing baseball diamond as a first base and shortstop. He was even active in any infield position. King Von hated playing outfield and catcher. However, it wasn't all fun and games like proper baseball should be. Given the environment that he was in at the moment, King Von didn't experience it as regular baseball, as it has its own hazards. Most players had to take a gun to baseball practice, and in several interviews, King Von admitted that it wasn't right. It would be a disaster to see fights break out at baseball practice among high school kids who could whip out a gun and shoot at any moment. Number 5. Turned to a life of crime at an early age. King Von's experience with crime and being locked up started when he was in middle school, or even before then. What were you doing when you were in middle school? Typically, kids that age would be worried about being forced to eat vegetables or not getting enough playtime. However, King Von at that age was stealing bikes until he finally went to jail by the time he turned 16. This was the first of many times that he would see the walls of a cell. He was arrested and booked for unlawful possession of a firearm. From that moment until about a decade later, King Von was never out of prison for a full year. By the time he was supposed to graduate from high school, he was already in jail and couldn't make it to the event. Then he had spent a lot of time in juvie. Number 4. He almost got sent to jail for about 100 years. This may seem like an exaggeration, but it's actually true. King Von was only 19 years old when he was arrested in connection with a May 2014 shooting. In that incident, one man was killed and two others injured. The men, which included Malcolm Stuckey, were sitting on their front porch. However, it looked like someone had an unfinished beef with them and opened fire directly at the men. Malcolm was hit on the head with a bullet and died on the scene. However, the other two were lucky to survive the terrible shooting. Not long after, King Von and Michael Wade were arrested as suspects. The police held them without bond and charged them with the crime. They both spent more than 3 years in prison before they were finally taken to trial. In this trial session that lasted only 5 days, Michael Wade got sentenced to more than 20 years in prison, while King Von walked out a free man, narrowly missing being locked away for the rest of his life. Number 3. Lil Durk helped him discover his talent. While King Von was in jail, he decided it was time to turn his life around. Good thing, too, as he had spent too much time fighting with the law. King Von got inspired by rappers like Gucci Mane and Lil Wayne, which got him rapping. However, it was when he hooked up with Lil Durk, who was his friend and mentor, that he was finally able to hit the rap scene with guns blazing, but not real guns this time. Within 6 months of hanging out with Lil Durk, King Von released several viral hits and started gaining some credibility in the industry. Not too long after, he was signed to Lil Durk's label and released Crazy Story in 2018. This song was a smash hit, with the remix gaining more than 30 million views on YouTube. Number 2. He was a huge LeBron James fan. The wordplay on his album LeVon James wasn't just wordplay, but a reflection of how much of a LeBron James fan he was. However, before he was able to release this album, trouble came calling again. This time it was both Lil Durk and King Von that got charged for attempted murder. In the incident, that took place outside the Varsity in Atlanta, Georgia, a man had been robbed by two men and then shot outside the famous drive-in sometime in February 2019. According to prosecutors, the man left with more than $300,000 in cash while also stealing a Jeep Cherokee. Since the victim was able to recover with just a gunshot wound to his leg, and their attorneys claimed it was in self-defense, King Von was eventually released on a $3,000 bail. A few days later, Lil Durk also gained his freedom. Having escaped jail time once more, King Von released his debut album, Grandson Volume 1, that September, and LeVon James in early March 2020. The sophomore album peaked at number 63 on the Billboard Top 200 charts, gaining him a steady rise to the top until he was unfortunately killed. Number 1. He was killed by Timothy Leeks. Sadly, King Von can't produce any music for his fans, as he was killed in early November 2020. The 26-year-old rapper was caught in the middle of a gunfight outside Monica Hookah Lounge in Atlanta. It started with an argument with another group of men that became an all-out brawl. However, what was supposed to be a night of celebration ended with confusion and King Von's death. The man who pulled the trigger, Timothy Leeks, had pointed the gun at King Von when the rapper started jumping Quando Rondo. While trying to save his friend, he shot at King Von, and this was all captured via the surveillance camera outside the club. And that brings us to the end of today's list. Is there any fact about King Von that we missed out on? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, don't forget to leave a like on this video, and if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button for all future content. Thanks for watching, until next time.